You would have learnt about vegetative propagation in your lower grades. What do you think about the following questions? Is vegetative propagation a type of asexual reproduction? If yes, why do you say so? Is the term clone applicable to the offsprings formed by vegetative propagation? Well, if you've not thought about it, think about it for a bit before you proceed. While in animals and other simple organisms, the term asexual reproduction is used, in plants, the term vegetative propagation is frequently used. The units of vegetative propagation, such as runners, rhizome, suckers, tubers, offsets, and bulbs are all capable of giving rise to new offspring. These structures are called vegetative propagules. Obviously, since the formation of these structures does not involve two parents, the process involved is asexual. Have you heard of this plant called water hyacinth? It is called Terror of Bengal. It is one of the most invasive weeds found growing wherever there is standing water. Well, it is a terror because it spreads so quickly and also drains oxygen from the water, which leads to death of fishes. It was actually introduced in India because of its beautiful flowers and the shape of leaves. Since it can propagate vegetatively at a phenomenal rate and spread all over the water body in a short period of time, it is very difficult to get rid of them. If you have been keen in observing how plants like potato, sugarcane, banana, ginger are cultivated, you would have seen small plants emerging from buds, called eyes of the potato tuber, or from the rhizomes of banana and ginger. If you carefully try to determine the site of origin of these new plantlets, you will notice that they invariably arise from the nodes present in the modified stems of these plants. When the nodes come in contact with damp soil or water, they produce roots and therefore new plants. Similarly, adventitious buds arise from the notches present at margins of leaves of bryophyllum. This ability is fully exploited by gardeners and farmers for commercial propagation of such plants. From an examination point of view, you will need to know a list of different vegetative propagules in different plants. And here it goes.